So today I want to talk about how oil and gas and information technology tend to be at odds with each other. And I'll give you an example of why I think that seems to be with a story. Most of the time when I go talk, I get one question almost every time. I have mostly technologists, software engineers, people working in the IT space in the room. And the question that I get is often, how are you guys working to reduce the use of hydrocarbons in the world? And how are you guys working to reduce energy consumption? And essentially what the folks mean when they say that is, how are you working to destroy the oil and gas industry? Well, my answer is always something that goes along these lines. And it's a reality check for how the world actually works. So let's talk about energy density first. Energy is in a gallon of oil or a gallon of gasoline is about 10 quadrillion times more dense than solar energy. So that's 10 with 15 zeros behind it. That is an incredible number, and there's no way you're going to get your head wrapped around that. So I'll give you one little tiny example of what that number means. I could take dollar bills and I could lay them out from the Earth to Venus, not once, not twice, not three times, 30 different times I could make that trip. And then if we talk about solar, so solar's a big deal. There's wind farms all over my beautiful home state of Oklahoma. A gallon of gasoline is about a billion times more energy dense than wind and water energy. So energy density is an incredibly important part of why oil and gas is so critical for us now, has been in the past, and will be in the future. And we just aren't ready to get away from that, because if it didn't exist, if we didn't have oil and gas, we would either have to invent it or we wouldn't be alive. And let me show you another example in another chart. Let's talk about the population growth. So from about 3000 BC or so, anything we can kind of guesstimate around in terms of population growth, until about 1800, the population of the entire planet was under a billion people, and usually hovering around 300 million or so. So for a long time, and then we got better at farming, and we started to get a bigger population growth. Then, 1859, a man named Drake drilled the first production oil and gas well, and production of hydrocarbons, production of oil, skyrocketed in the US and across the world. And something else skyrocketed then as well, the population. The population went from just around a billion to today, which is 7.4 billion people. So let's put that in context. That's right about in here is everybody you know and all their family and all their friends, and everybody you've ever met and all their family and all their friends, and everybody you've ever seen and all their family and all their friends, and everybody you've ever seen on TV and all their family and all their friends. And that's right about here is where you're at. There are about 6.5 other billion people, and the reason those people can live is because of hydrocarbons, because of the energy density, the ease of transportation, the non-volatility, and the other things we do with it. So, give you some more context. Everything you're touching right now, everything that and how it was delivered, how it was made, how you got it to you, how you can look at it through your glasses. Probably most everything that is around you right now is either made from, produced with, transported by hydrocarbons, on top of that you are alive today because of hydrocarbons. So with that context, let's talk about why oil and gas and IT should really come together. So that's normally the context I give, so let's talk about why. So oil and gas is an old industry, and the people who run it tend to be scared or reluctant to adopt technology. And that's not a good thing, because it is a proven thing. The information technology done well, done in the way where it's usable and highly functional and really well engineered, can change industries. It can create satellites that can see the whole Earth, and we have mapping technology that is unprecedented in the history of the world. We can send information to our grandma in California and we can have a FaceTime with our children and our grandchildren and our grandmother and 10 generations all at once if we wanted to. So technology is amazing, and every industry it's been applied to has been changed fundamentally and in really positive ways where they're more efficient and faster and safer and people know more. The oil and gas industry has been extremely slow to adopt oil and gas. And one of the problems with that is because oil and gas is dirty and it's hard, and you can't go out there with nice shoes on, and you have to have fire retardant suits, and you have to have steel-toed boots. And that's what you need to work and to make usable software in the oil and gas industry. So technologists have been unbelievably reluctant or unable to conceive that. Or the oil and gas industry has been burned many times by bad technology and won't adopt it. We have to solve that. We need more technologists to come into the industry. That's what we're doing. We've brought together the best engineers, in some of the best in the world, together to solve the real problems in the industry. We have a little phrase that we like to say, and it's data in the cloud and boots on the ground. And that's something we really believe in. We send our engineers out to the field because it's important to make technology that is unbelievably useful, and not just so that we can build a business, but for the safety and lives of the people out there, because they can't have unusable software. So my ask to all you technologists out there is, come see what this industry is about, because you are literally alive because of it. And to all the oil and gas companies who we're working with and who are out there, you can have a better business and a safer, more efficient, more productive, more powerful business if you use fantastic oil and gas technology. These industries must and will be brought together, and we hope to be at least a small part of that bridge.